Welcome back. Just for Annie McManus, great ropey. She felt great when she arrived, but ropey when she left. Party goer. Champagne on ice here for Ronan again. Six more rounds to come. Greg, let's get more letters from you.
Can I have a constant, please?
Thank you, Greg. M.
And another, please.
P.
And another, please.
R.
And one more, please.
N.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another, please.
E.
And another, please.
A.
And a consonant, please.
D.
Yeah, and a vowel, please.
Lastly, I.
Okay, let's play. Down, Greg.
Six.
And Ronan.
Eight.
And eight, Greg.
Primed.
Primed, and we're primed for the eight.
Impaired.
Impaired. Wow, a word that does not apply to you, Ronan. Sensational. Dictionary
Excellent.
Corner, what would you like to say? Would you like to add a word or just pay tribute?
We would like to add a word, eight letters, meridian.
Meridian.
Yeah.
Brilliant. 87 plays 12. Ronan, your letters.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Ronan. T.
And another.
S.
And another.
J.
Vowel.
A.
And another.
U.
And another.
E.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
I.
And I'll finish with a consonant, please.
Finish with H.
And an H. Countdown. Number, Mr. Higginson?
Eight.
Mr. Rain?
Oh, just a five.
Greg, let's enjoy this together.
Yeah.
Let's just make this an afternoon you and I are going to love, because we're in the same boat. What's the five, mate?
I've got tries. I'm trying.
Yeah, you're trying the best, mate. Ronan?
I'm not sure how to pronounce it. Thesauri?
Thesauri, plural of thesaurus. Absolutely brilliant in the dictionary there.
Has there ever been a more applicable word
<That's true. laughs>
for somebody to get?
That's also what we had.
Yeah. Greek for treasure house, remember, a thesaurus.
Let's go back to dictionary corner then. Origins of words. Well, origins of phrases all this week, Susie.
Yes, last one of the week. And this is someone no one wants around. A peeping Tom.
Ooh.
And I think quite a few people know the sort of legend attached to Peeping Tom, and that involves Lady Godiva and her very famous horse ride from the 11th century. So the story, if you remember, is that Lady Godiva pleaded with her husband, who was the Earl of Mercia, over his treatment of the people, and particularly taxes that he was imposing on them, even the poorest. And he became increasingly exasperated, so the story goes, and he came up with a bet that he thought would end the argument. And he said he would lower his taxes if Lady Godiva rode through the streets of Coventry completely naked. In other versions of the story, this was a protest by her. It wasn't something that he organised. But anyway, whatever happened, she did, according to the story, meet his challenge and make the ride. And before setting off, because this was such a sort of momentous occasion, but one that people really shouldn't be witnessing, the people of Coventry were told to stay indoors, to close their shutters, close their doors and not look out as Lady Godiva rode by. But according to the story, the whole town did as they were asked to, apart from one man, who was Tom the tailor, who was unable to resist and peeked through his shutters. And in the main story that you will hear, he was instantly struck blind. So it's quite a sort of myth that has, you know, grown up around Lady Godiva. Whether or not it's true, we're not sure. We're not even sure if Lady Godiva did actually create that or undertake that horse ride. And we don't know whether Peeping Tom really was there. But it is recorded from quite early on. So it's quite possible that there were witness accounts or accounts of this, even if it was a legend at the time, that that have grown and grown and grown. And it's definitely because of the story that a Peeping Tom still has that meaning of a voyeur that no one wants around today.
Love origins of phrases. Hopefully we'll have another week of them soon. It's been an absolute treat. Thank you, Susie. OK, four rounds of countdown left before we break for the weekend. My new mate, Greg, you're up.
Can I have a constant, please?
Thank you, Greg. S.
And another, please.
T.
And another, please.
P.
And one more, please.
C.
And a vowel, please.
O.
And another, please.
A.
And another, please.
O.
And one more, please.
E.
And a consonant, please.
Lastly, G.
Good luck. Greg?
Oh, I'll just go with a five.
Yeah, and Ronan?
Seven.
And the seven. What's the five, Greg?
Cages.
What's this big seven?
Postage.
Postage. Buying on the money. Dictionary corner. What have you got?
We've got another seven with capotes.
Yes. Centuries ago, they were hooded cloaks.
Great. And Ronan gets his century up again. Three on the bounce. One more letters round. And it's yours, champ.
Start with the vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Ronan. A.
And another?
E.
And a third?
U.
Consonant?
D.
And another?
R.
And another?
W.
And another?
R.
Vowel?
O.
And I'll finish with a consonant, please.
Finish with S.
Last letters. Seconds up, Ronan.
Seven.
And Greg.
That's six.
The six for me, Greg.
Erodes.
Yes, very good. And Ronan.
Rewards.
Seven's going to score, Susie.
Yes, absolutely excellent. You need two E's for erodes, though. Yeah. But we couldn't do better than seven.
Okay, can you dazzle me with loads of sevens?
We had arrowed, we had aroused, and we had drosera.
A drosera?
Drosera is an insect-eating plant called the sundew.
Of course it is. Lovely. Any of those words would have scored you seven as we head towards our last numbers. Greg, go for your life.
Have one large, please.
You can indeed. Final time today, and hopefully 10 more points hidden in these numbers, which are 10. There you go. It's a sign. 7, 2, 4, 1 and 75. And the final target of the week. Ooh, 938.
938, last numbers. Greg?
No, miles off.
Yeah, the countdown god's not favouring yet. What are you saying, Ronan?
Just 940.
OK, two away for 7 points.
Not written down, sorry.
Doesn't matter, off you go.
7 times 2?
7 times 2, 14.
Plus 75.
Plus 75, 89.
Plus 4, plus 1.
4 and the 1, 94.
And times a 10.
And that gets you 2 away. Lovely.
938. Are you going to finish the week on a high?
I am.
Yes.
Found a couple of ways. One of them, 4 + 7 = 11. 75 + 10 = 85. Times those two together for 935 and add on the remaining one and 2938.
Good, well done. Well, here we are at the end of another countdown week. It has been spectacular. Ronan Higginson with his third win, his third century, comfortably, by the way. Greg, you're going to be on quite a list, I think, if I can see into the countdown future. But your story of countdown conundrums has been interesting. 29 yeah. seconds, you got it, and then first 1 second yesterday, but got it wrong.
No, I did, yeah.
So you never know here, Greg. Let's get your finger on that buzzer. 10 points up for grabs. And it's always a delight if you can get today's countdown conundrum. 1 second, Ronan.
Bubbliest.
Let's have a look. Yes. So in on times, if you are less than 0.5, it gets rounded down, right? I'm not sure that got to 0.5. I think that was in 0 seconds, right? Well, we'll time it back, Ronan, after the show.
Yeah.
But I think we might have just had a countdown conundrum on zero, which is just sensational. Huge round of applause for Ronan. That was great. Greg, you've been on all types of hell today, but, you know, will you go away with a little bit of a smile on your face?
Oh, I think so. I've had a good time, to be fair. So, yeah. No, I'm really happy just to be on, really. And I mean, there was one numbers one that I've, as soon as I saw it, I didn't get it. But apart from that, I wouldn't have got anything anyway. Yeah. So it was just like, yeah.
Yeah, we might have to bring a computer into play at some stage. We'll see. I've been trying to be on your side, though, the whole way through.
I appreciate it.
I'll have one more go, because it's not all about countdown. Ronan, can you grow a moustache yet?
Don't think so.
No, you can't. Just remember that, Ronan. Just remember. You have a good weekend. We'll see you Monday.
Yeah, we'll see you Monday.
Thank you for being here, Greg.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Annie, absolute personal and professional delight to have you here
this week. Lovely
Thank
to
you.
Be here. Thank you.
Probably see you at the weekend anyway.
Yeah. Susie. Look forward to that.
I can't grow a moustache either, so Greg's got one up on me as well.
Absolutely love it. Right, we're done. We'll be back on Monday. I just wanted, before we finish, to be serious, just put out a personal plea. There are 5 people out there right now who are due to appear on Countdown next week. Please turn up. Rachel, Susie and I will be here. You can count on us.
You can contact the programme by email at countdown@channel4.com. You can also find our webpage at channel4.com/countdown.
4 designers who have never owned their own home remain in the race to win the big interiors battle, and tonight they're getting creative in the living room. That's at 8. Next this afternoon, looking for the perfect pad overseas. Sun, sea and selling houses on the way.